Today we're going to talk about finishes on watches. And when we talk about finishes, I am not talking about refinishing or anything like that. We're talking about the actual applied finishes to watches. When you make a watch movement, you basically start out with a block of brass. You could take the finishing on that to the extreme and by applying different finishes to the movement itself. Some of the finishes that we do, Côtes de Genève, which are actually stripes across it. Why do they use it? Why is it called that? Because Geneva steel watches have to carry that. If you look at two Pateks, one that's Geneva steel, it's gonna have the Côtes de Genève. If you have a newer Patek seal, it's gonna have a completely different finish because it doesn't fall into that category. Different finishes are perlage. It's basically pearl finish. It's little circles, just hundreds and thousands of little circles all over the movement of different sizes. And they go in a spiral fashion, overlapping each other. Absolutely beautiful. They're all applied by hand. Each little circle is applied by hand. And it's an absolutely beautiful finish. It's a very, very time-consuming finish on it, though. Other parts of watch finishing are engraving, anglage, which is chamfering. What the anglage does, it's every smooth surface you have, you're putting a polished edge on it. It could be straight, it could be a curved edge, and it's everything's done by hand with that. And you add beveling too. So there's three ways to really say the same thing. About the only difference is when you talk about beveling, you could have bevels that aren't high polished. So if it's anglage, it's gonna be very high polished. Bevels can be satined, and it's just basically to make the piece look thinner than it is. One of the skills that I've never been able to really master, although I never really tried either, is hand engraving. It's where you either draw a design into the movement itself, you could do it into the case, you could do it into the dials, and you basically hold the tool and you turn the component underneath. You can't push the tool into it because it's gonna slip. So you're actually moving the piece of work underneath a tool that you're holding and just kind of guiding in pressure. When you talk about the engraving too, you can also talk about skeletonized movements because those kind of go hand in hand. A lot of times you'll see a skeletonized movement, which is just a base movement, and they remove as much metal as you practically can. Again, you're just adding more and more angles to capture light into that, and a lot of times actually see light through it. One of the fun things we see in watches too, in the higher finish watches, is we see blued screws or black polish screws. A true blued screw is a screw that's heated up till it gets to the scale where it actually starts to turn color. So when you're doing blued screws for a watch movement, you want them all the same, and that's the hard part to do. So you're gonna make a plate out of brass, you're gonna put all the screws for that watch and heat them up evenly on that plate of brass. You're gonna heat the plate of brass and it's gonna heat everything up, and when it gets to the color you want, you stop, you pull the heat, and that's the color of your screws. So it's very hard to replace a blued screw if you're missing one. We make screws all the time for watches, and if you have a blued one, it's very hard to get to match the color. Then we talk about black polished. Black polish is a mirror finish, and it's done on a very, very hard surface. All the metal has to be hardened. It could be a spring, it could be pretty much any component, any steel component within that watch. The way we black polish is we polish down actually using a zinc block and diamond dust. And we get all the scratches out. You have to start with basically a mirror finish, then you polish it again. It turns so shiny that it actually absorbs all the light and reflects back black. One of the other finishes we see on movements, on wheels or different components, are snail finishes. And snail finishes are pretty cool because it's actually a spiral that rolls outside of the wheels. The way that's done is you actually have to have two lathes offset to one another. So you have one piece of metal spinning here, the piece you want to finish, and you have another piece of metal spinning here, and they're offset. And so they're actually spinning in opposite directions, and it actually gets a swirl finish as it goes around. And it's a really cool finish. A lot of high-end watches use that. We talk about brands that are known for high-end finishing. FP Journe, they use solid gold movements. They do a perlage finish on them. They're absolutely gorgeous pieces when you see it finished. If you talk about Geneva steel watches, you have Patek. The older Pateks, not the Patek seal watches, but the older Geneva seal watches. Vacheron, the older Vacheron pieces all have Geneva seal. Roger Dubuis are all Geneva seal pieces. So anytime you work on one of those, anytime I work on one of those watches, I take extra time. I wrap each piece up. I wrap each piece as I'm cleaning it. The screws don't get washed with everything else because we don't want to scratch the screws. The wheels get separated. No components are put together to where they get bounced together. So there's ways to make it. Then once it's made, you have to protect it. Then there's the new finishes now. If you want to talk about very high-end finishes, we have the new Patek seal, which is a different finish, and it actually took Geneva seal up one step further. You have the Fleurier seal, which all those watches have to come from Fleurier. and that takes everything up another step further too. Personally, I've done a lot of different finishing. One of my favorite to do is perlage. That's one of my favorite finishes just because it gives so many angles to reflect that light. As I said, it's very, very time consuming. It's very, very precise, but it gives you a lot of flexibility because you can go from small holes, to big circles, to little circles. And it's just, you could change and vary it so much. You take perlage, you add it to some anglage around it, around the bridges and everything, and everything just lights up so much. So these are finishes that I've done. These are finishes that I really like too. We talk about some of the other finishes on movements. On a Richard Mill, everything's black. There's no finish to it, but it's a skeletonized movement that's completely black. It is unbelievably delicate. That's one of the movements. It has proprietary screws that I won't even attempt to take apart. I know what the surface is on them. I know what the movement replacement cost is on them. I wouldn't even attempt it. But you also have like a Hublot Unico, which is a powder coated finish. More utilitarian, same thing. It'll scratch. It's an applied finish on top of it. It's actually not into the metal itself. One of the last processes when you're putting the finish into a movement, remember you're starting with a brass plate and brass is yellow. So then you have to rhodium plate it. So you go through and you have to do the cleaning process, you have to do the nickel process, then you do the rhodium plating, and that's when the movement actually turns white. A lot of brands are starting to do other finishes too. Ruthenium finishes, which is a dark gray. It looks absolutely beautiful when you put it in with all the polished screw heads. So there's different combinations of metals you can use, different combinations of finishes to get the color. But once you have to start with a brass blank, then you put the finish on it, then you can go from there and add the different colors, whether you want to gold plate it, whether you want to do anything else to it. I'm Michael Michaels. I hope you enjoyed my take on watch finishing. Hope you'll check out my Instagram. Leave your comments. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more content like this.